Your god told you there can be only one. She said you'll eventually need to turn on each other.
But this is how they work. Divide us, then conquer us, one by one. I won't have it. Family's family.
Like I'd ever listen to some spook at the peril of my friends. Not in this lifetime.
A girl's best friend is her needle. But I'll stick by you as long as you continue to uphold your particular brand of useful.
I always knew I'd die for Rivalon. I just didn't expect it was going to be in a small basement. In Driftwood, of all places. At least now you know where to go. I was dying anyway. The Magister's purging made certain of that. I should probably send the Void a thank you bouquet. At least they were efficient about it. No. Today my death is not important. All that matters is that you find Malady and tell her the location of the Council. Just be wary. She is immensely powerful, and she is on our side. But she will not be pleased about, well, my parting. She may ask you to honor an old bargain that I had struck with her. Do not accept. Her business is with me, and me alone.
She glances at her body once more, a grim look on her face.
You need to go, Godwoken. But I have one last request. My last wish, as it were. I want a statue. Something modest. A simple piece of marble and gold on the steps of the cathedral, glaring out over Arx.
Maester Siva's shoulders slump, a tired, melancholic grin on her muzzle.
I would have liked to see that city again. Just once more. Give them hell, Godwoken.
It seems to be the code to a safe. Better hang on to this.
The masked creature is mute, save the occasional moan. The spirit gives you a tortured glance, then turns away to stare at nothing in particular.
The air buzzes with sores here.
Such indecency. You strike a man in his own household. I believe we have a friendly agreement. It would be a shame if you refuse to honor it. No harm done, then. But do avoid acting in haste. The world does not look kindly on such fundamental mistakes. How marvelous.
Riker's lips tremble impatiently as his eyes dart to your pack.
Show it to me.
He considers you for a moment.
Very well.
Riker closes his eyes and spreads his arms, then begins to recite a vivid incantation.
I called the souls of the dead. Your remains, the stone garden's eternal burden, descend from the hall. Surrender your source to the vessel before me.
Riker's voice grows even louder, drowning your words in a deluge of his own.
Swan and Rince, Crossley and Locke, Quincy, Keller, Harkwood, Haran, an essence yours no longer, souls and source come forth.
Your body convulses with Zol Stiss's displeasure. Your head pounds, your bones ache. Riker's smile widens at the sight of your agony.
So this is how your path to divinity ends, is it? No matter. I've kept my promise. But there is another bargain I must fulfill. A shame it has to be this way. I was just getting fond of you.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Okay.
Careful! I've spotted a trap!
Ready.
Why?
The spirit's lips curl into a sneer.
Don't look so pleased with yourself. You're too quick to act, too green still. Mastery was there for the taking, yet you refused it. I've nothing left to show you, and nothing left to say. Take what you must from my home, but my memories and masteries, they remain with me.
His sneer is now a gash, wide and gruesome. You can barely believe one spirit could harbor so much contempt. His face only contorts further, a testament to his unmitigated contempt. Your scales tremble and your tongue is numb. Your inner source pours into him and his into you. The graveyard. You look down at your mangled hand, then towards a shimmering spirit standing ahead. A feast awaits. You reach out your gnarled hand. The victimized spirit writhes in agony as you siphon its source into your failing body. Your hand straightens before your very eyes. The wrinkles smooth and the age spots fade. The pulsing blue veins that once crisscrossed are now unseen, hidden under newly taut skin. Your efforts are useless. Your hold on Riker's spirit has weakened, and a final vision crashes into view. You slip on your spectacles and hold the parchment to your eyes. As the script comes into focus, you see the words Black Ring near the bottom, and you are thrust into the reality to become fully you.
There is but one promise I have ever regretted making. One deal I have ever sought to break. That tablet, the template to the Swornbreaker. It was the key to my freedom. Alas, I remain sworn. Yet, I take some comfort in knowing that the Black Ring comes for you, Godwoken. The lone wolves will collect on their contract.
You couldn't imagine it possible, but the spirit's scorn only grows. Riker may be silent, but his feelings are hardly secret. The spirit stares daggers into you, but says,
Well, this is quite the antiques collection.
Lucky find.
You see yourself in the mirror. It's quite a sight.
I hear a door opening.
Go on, then. Ah, yes. I am the Prime Scion. A revelation that came quite out of the blue, which is somewhat ironic, considering I'm supposed to be my people's foremost memory keeper. Quite slipped my mind, though. A slave scar will do that to a girl. To be frank, it exasperates.
She looks down, an uncharacteristic cast of melancholy passing over her face.
Gods, I was so young. Imagine it, to sit enthroned under a vast forest canopy, to look down upon a crowd of thousands, their bodies aglow with countless rays of golden light falling through the leaves. You hear their voices as one. One mind, one thought, and it's your name they incant, as if the word itself were magic. Sabile. They said it like I was the cornerstone of their existence. Isn't that silly? I didn't even know myself. It's a very lonely thing, indeed, to be the object of a people's worship. What is revered is feared at the same time.
She absent-mindedly fingers her needle. Hesitates.
I used to love poetry. I used to love wandering the forests for days on end. I'd swim in the rivers and forget to dress after. It was fine. I was alone. I'd bask in the sun, sleep nestled among bear cubs. Nothing out there would harm me. But always they would find me, the Scions. Always the Mother Tree would call me back, for one day I'd be free no longer. One day my legs would be roots. To wander would be but one lone memory among millions. Clearly not. Though I must admit that even to sit on that throne amid that eerie crowd, destined to become leaf and bark, was not so dreadful a prospect as what came next. When I decided to run away from the Mother Tree with only the moon for my guide, it was a terrible journey. Soft-leafed branches became vicious like whips. Moss-bedecked rocks became sharp like the stone axes of old. I grew weary. I was bleeding. In pain, and how I gasped when for the first time an animal eyed me with malice and growled. That is when I heard them. The whispers and the taunts. The low howls of men. The snare cut so deep. The blindfold, it made me panic. The dark.
Somewhat to your surprise, Sabile doesn't recoil. But allows you to hug her.
Thank you. That very first moment of darkness. I've never been so scared ever since. Then there was the stench of those men. The burn of the ropes. The jeers and the kicks. Until the dark went silent. Even those barbarians didn't dare speak in the presence of the Master. But I'll not speak of him and his methods. Not now, anyway. If ever.
this again. This is quite the antiques collection. Lucky find. Nice. Flesh and bone severed and stitched. Perhaps some sort of necromancy.
The paying spirit moans in fits and starts. It speaks no words, but no matter. Its contorted face betrays the torture it endures. The paying spirit moans in fits and starts. The paying spirit moans in fits.
This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection.
Garbage.
All this knowledge hidden from inquisitive minds. Such a pity.
What?
This is quite the antiques collection.
Nice.
I can feel my source power draining at the merest touch. Tenebrium is truly a material of the void. My lucky day, a third pyramid.
This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection.
blessed be.
This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection. This again.
And you thought Rivellon was flat.